forward, please. It's my honor to tell you about David. I'd like you to turn to page 4 in the program, and you can read some of the fantastic details of his playing career and his coaching career. Whatever level he was at, either as a player or as a coach, he excelled. When I sat down to eat today, Bob Picken came up to our table and just said that he had just finished interviewing David for the Hall of Fame. And, you know, he said how I could describe it. And I think it's a perfect description of David. He said the interview was bubbly. Secondly, if you look at the picture in the program, and it's the picture that's going to be enshrined in our Hall of Fame, you might say, hey kid, wash your face. But you know what? I think that's an appropriate picture for David to be remembered by. He was always a hustler, a scrapper. If he was on your team, you loved the guy. If he was on the other team, not so much. After his tremendous playing career, he was on just so many championship teams that there are too many to mention. And the other thing too is if his team wasn't there, somebody always picked him up to go and play with him. Since his retirement from active playing, he's taken a real leadership role in the development of baseball in this province through companies like Rookies and the Home Run Sports Academy and the college development program. He's given hundreds of kids the opportunity to develop their skills, get better as players, travel down into the States to play against tough competition on great facilities, to make contact with colleges down in the States, to maybe have the opportunity to go down and play somewhere down in the States as David did. And he's providing that opportunity to a lot of young baseball players that 10 or 15 years ago never had that opportunity. So to finish it off, I just like to welcome David Nychyk into the Manitoba Baseball Hall of Fame.
It's not that long. I just have to write it. I can't read it. Didn't want to put it all. All right. So first of all, I'd like to thank the Hall of Fame Board of Directors. It's a great honor. I'm very humbled to be put into the Hall of Fame. There's so many great players that have been around this game. They're in, and some are not. But it's just so humbling to be a part. It's outstanding. First of all, I'd like to thank my thank yous. Of course, I'd like to thank my wife, Wanda. My time, my commitment. She has to stand by me at all times. It's a lot of time. I'm on the field through my career as well as through coaching, so I thank her. My kids, Taylor and Owen, my inspiration. My brother taught me to play for the boys. That was the most important thing. Always play for your teammates, always love that. And of course, my mom. Mom used to take me 3 bus rides. Was at 8 years old, I wanted to play baseball. I didn't want to play fast pitch, three base, 3 bus rides to get there, Sacred Heart, and I gotta say thanks. I'm lucky enough to play with a lot of great coaches. Funny thing about this, is one of my favorite coaches of all time, and no one knows this, is being inducted in the same year I am, Mr. Thompson. So, outstanding. I was so surprised that I see his face, and it was such an inspiration to be as my back midget coach. He kept everything real, and it was he's outstanding. Thank you, Mr. Thompson. Between him and Larry Mudge, they gave me inspiration to play baseball. Guy Constant, Donnie Smith, Morgan DePena, who's our coach in Toulon, all great coaches. And of course, I finished off my career playing for Scott Barry. He taught me a lot about life, and I thank him every day that he taught me how to appreciate the game, appreciate life. Thank you, Scott. I now have a couple coaches that I currently coach with, Johnny Alley and Andy Halpenny. They push me and make me change every day and make sure that I'm okay to change with the game, because the state game is changing all the time. So now, I know how much fun this game is. Just try and pass this on to the kids, because I know how much fun this is. I'm trying to give kids their dreams, because I know how much fun I have. Some of my fondest dreams, Toulon Gardens. Winning the Western Canadian Championship, Morgan DePena coaching that team, us winning the three-time Western Canadian Championship, Red Deer Raiders with Oil Cannon on the mound. One of the funniest stories ever, and one of the great memories. Finished off my career, winning it with the Elmwood Giants with some lifelong friends, and that was something that I'll always cherish. And then the time we beat the national team with an all-star team from Manitoba. We had a national team that came across the nation, they beat on Maritimes, they beat on Quebec, they beat on Ontario, they kicked off to Winnipeg, and we beat them. We hammered them 17-9. Kevin Booker, who's in the seedings right now, 2 home runs, bombs. Thanks, Kevin. What's the great thing about that is no one really knows this story. I had to leave the park early because my family was having a dinner. And I had to walk by the Canadian team, and all they had was plates in their hands. And the coach walked up and down them and says, "Get your dinner, get on the bus, we're leaving for Saskatoon tonight." And the Winnipeg boys took it to them. I think that's one of the proudest moments of ours, that we can still play baseball here. We can still play baseball here, and that's one of the most inspirational things that I try to pass on to my kids. So thank you very much, and those that can remember this, safe home.